I'm going to show you step by step how to set up Pro Tools and the Dolby Atmos renderer. I'm using the Dolby Atmos Production Suite, which is the easiest way to get started since you don't need a separate computer to make it work. I'm going to show you how to get started with the sessions routing, and at the end, I'm going to show you how to bounce your mix for distribution. So the reason I wanted to make this video is because I couldn't find a simple step-by-step tutorial to follow and get started right away. Every tutorial I saw was either too tedious and too technical or had things that I had to troubleshoot in order to get started. So the first thing you want to do is go and download the Dolby Atmos renderer and the Dolby Atmos panner and install it. You can get a trial version for 90 days, which I think is a great option to get started. I'll put the download links in the description below. Just a quick disclaimer that this is very simplified and you should definitely go and read more about it if you're interested. There's a lot of material on the Dolby website and there's a lot of resources out there you can learn. Once you have it and installed it, open up Pro Tools. I'm working with Pro Tools Ultimate 2022.7.0. Now, go to Setup, Playback Engine, and select the Dolby Audio Bridge. It is recommended to set your hardware buffer size to be at least 1024 samples. You need to do this first so Pro Tools is not set up to your main interface. Press OK and let Pro Tools close. Now launch the Dolby Atmos renderer software. The next step is setting up the communication between the renderer and Pro Tools. Go to the preference page and set the audio driver to core audio. Set the audio input device to the Dolby audio bridge. You want to set the audio output device to the interface you're using. For Pro Tools, for this I'm using HD Native Thunderbolt. Set the LTC input to 129. If it's not already. If you want to start working using headphones only, select the headphone only mode. We're gonna set everything at 24 frames per second. Sample rate is gonna be 48K. Go to the headphone pane, engage headphone processing and set to binaural. Press accept. Now start Pro Tools. You don't need to create a new session yet. In Pro Tools, open up the peripheral window by navigating to setup peripherals. Click the Dolby Atmos tab. Click the enable checkbox. The indicator will be flashing green, so you have to change the host. From the drop-down menu, select your machine as the host. Once you do that, the connection status indicator will be solid green. As you can see, it's already solid green on my system because it was already saved. But most likely when you open up yours, it's not gonna be like that. Press OK. Okay, now let's create a new blank session. Set the sample rate at 48K. And change the IO setting to Dolby Atmos Renderer Dolby Audio Bridge Stereo and create it. Now go to Session Setup or press Command 2. Set the session start at 1 hour and set all the rates to 24. Now let's configure the IO. From the bus tab, click on the drop-down menu to the right of the default button and change from all buses to use Atmos Renderer. Click default, and both the output and bus tab will automatically use the input configuration that the renderer is set to. Now we need to add the LTC output. Go to the output tab, click new path, select mono. You can name it LTC 129, press create, and then press OK. So now we need to create our actual track for the LTC. To create a new track, you can name it LTC 129. Set its output to 129 that we just created. And now insert the Dolby LTC generator plugin. Let's check the renderer is chasing Pro Tools. Make sure this sync button is selected in the renderer. Press play in Pro Tools. You should be able to see that the timecode is playing and in sync in both softwares. In Pro Tools, in the track view, enable the objects. The object button is going to be the main way you're going to assign your tracks to objects. From there, import your stems or create your tracks. Assign them all to the 7.1.2 bed. If you press play, you should be able to hear them and see that they are going through the renderer. It's also standard practice to set one aux to send directly to your sub channel or LFE. So let's create a mono aux and set the output to the mono LFE. Usually I would have a low pass filter on it, so you only send the low frequencies to it. I usually set the low pass filter at around 80 Hertz. And that's when you can start having fun, work on your production, do your mix. One important thing to keep in mind is that the standard as far as loudness goes for music in Dolby Atmos is minus 18 dBs integrated. So if you play the loudest part of your song and you are too loud, make sure you adjust things from the very beginning of you working on a mix or on a production, so you don't have to like fix things at the end when you want to bounce things down. So once you're done working on it, the simplest way of bouncing your mix is to use the bounce function in Pro Tools. So what you're gonna do is select the wave Dolby Atmos, and once you press bounce, it's gonna create a wave ADM file, which is most likely what distributors will ask for. For example, you can see here DistroKid, that's what they're requesting. Okay, that's all I have.